Hi, welcome back. This is Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about yet another application of dynamic programming, that is traveling salesman problem. But before we start, a small information I'd like to share. In this channel, we produce every video in two different languages. If you want to watch this video in Hindi, kindly follow the link given in the description. If you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get regular updates from this channel. So, let us start. As the name itself is saying, traveling salesman, let us say there is a salesman which is traveling around different cities, and after traveling all the cities, he has to come back to the starting point. So assume that the traveling salesman is starting from city 1, he can go to city 2, then come back to city 3, and then from city 3 to city 4, and from city 4, he comes back to the starting city, that is city 1. But then, is there any other way to travel? Yes, there are various ways of traveling. He can travel from 1 to 3 to 2 to 4 to 1 also. So you can see that there are various paths of travel. Which path to choose so that the cost of travel or the time of travel will be minimized? Basically, we used to associate this problem with a cost matrix. And I represent the value of the cost with CIC. And the cost may be distance, cost of travel, time of travel, it can be anything. And to represent it, we need an adjacency matrix. It means whenever there is an edge and a cost associated with it, I'll write the cost in I and jth location. And if there is no direct edge associated with any two cities, I'll write infinity. So, for this particular problem, I can represent it with this particular graph. From city 1 to city 2, let us say the cost of travel is 10, but from city 2 to city 1, the cost of travel is 5. So, in this manner, if I want to represent it, the adjacency matrix will look like this. Now, instead of saying city, we are saying vertices. Let us assume the traveling salesman is starting with vertex 1. Now, if he starts with vertex 1, then he can travel to either vertex 2, 3 or 4. Now, if he travels to vertex 2, then he is having two options. He can go to vertex 3 or vertex 4. And after going to vertex 3, he can go to vertex 4, again come back to his starting vertex, that is 1. Similarly, from 2, if he goes to 4, he can go to 3 and then to 1. Similarly, for all the other vertices. Basically, we are trying to have a brute force approach for solving it. Let us see. If you want to go to his destination, that is vertex 1, from vertex 4, how much he has to pay? He has to pay 8. So, 8 is written here. Similarly, if he is at vertex 3 and he want to go to vertex 1, he has to pay 6. Similarly, if he is at vertex 2 and want to go to vertex 1, he has to pay 5. 3 to 1 cost 6 and 2 to 1 cost is 5. Now, before coming to vertex 4, he might have started from vertex 3. If he is coming from vertex 3, the cost is 12. It means 3 to 4 cost is 12 and again 4 to 1 cost is 8. If he is at vertex 3 and he want to go to vertex 1, the cost of travel is 20. Similarly, if he is at vertex 4 and he want to travel to vertex 1, the cost of travel will be 15. Similarly, for all other vertices. Now, before coming to this vertex, he will be at vertex 2 or 3 or 4. Now, if he want to travel to vertex 1 from vertex 2, either he has to take this path or this path. So, which path he has to take? He has to take a path which will cost him the less. It means he has to take the minimum path and the cost from 2 to 4, that is 10. 15 plus 10, that is 25. Similarly, from vertex 3, if he is going to vertex 1, either he can go with this path or this path. But the smallest cost path is 13 plus 12. 13 is the cost from 4 to 1 and 12 is the cost from 3 to 4. Similarly, from vertex 4 to 1 if you want to go, the minimum cost required is 15 plus 8. Now with the same logic, if it's starting from vertex 1, the minimum cost we need to think about. And the cost 25 I got from this particular vertex. And the cost of travel from 1 to 2 is 10. So the total cost of travel or the minimized cost of travel from vertex 1 covering all the vertices, again going back to vertex 1, will be 35. I hope you understood it. How we found it? If we are at vertex 1, we need to travel to vertex 2, 3 or 4. It means the cost for vertex 1 to other vertices. And if I am traveling from 1 to 2, I must deduct this value from the set of 1, 2, 2. It means at the beginning, I am at vertex 1 and I have to travel to 2, 3, 4. And if I am traveling 1 to 2, the remaining are 3 and 4. So this is what we are going to do. Let us try to see this with the help of an example. So the formula that we will be using to find the minimum cost is this one. How we are going to use it? Don't worry, you will be able to understand it. So let us assume that before going to the starting vertex, he is at this particular level. It means he is either at vertex 4 or 3 or 2. It means it's the last vertex. And after that, he has to go back to his starting vertex. It means I want to find G of I 5. I means the vertex I am in and 5 means I don't have any other vertices to travel to. So I am going to use this particular formula. So G of I 5 equal to C I 1. It means the value I'll be getting is this particular column. G15 is C11, that is 0. G25 is C21, that is 5. G35 is 6 and G45 is 8. So I got the initial calculation. Now apply this particular formula. It means now we are at this particular level and after this level we have to go to this level and then to starting vertex. So how many options we are having? From 3 to 4, 4 to 3, 2 to 4, 4 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 2. It means I am having 6 different options. So in order to write it, I will be having G of 3, 4. It means I am at vertex 3 and I want to travel to vertex 4. It means what? Our set contains only one vertex. It means that before solving this problem, we are having an assumption that we are starting with vertex 1. And if he is at vertex 2, from there he can travel to vertex 3 or 4. Look at this. If he is at vertex 2, he can travel to vertex 3 or he can travel to vertex 4. So I will be having G of 2, 3 and G of 2, 4. In the same logic, if the salesman is at vertex 3, he will be traveling to either vertex 4, he will be traveling to the vertex 2. So I'll be finding G of 3, 2, 3, 4 and in the same logic G of 4, 2 and 4, 3. Let us try to find these values. Now we are having these value already we have calculated and we are going to apply this particular formula. What is that? G of IS equal to minimum of Cij plus G of J, S minus Ij for J belongs to S. Now let us try to find G of 2, 3. G of 2, 3 means minimum of J belongs to S, C of 2, 3 plus G of 3, 5. Whatever 3 we are having here, we'll write it here. Okay. And the remaining vertices, whatever is there from this particular vertex, we are going to write. It means 3 minus 3 is 5. We are already having that C 2, 3 is and G 3, 5 is 6. So the value we got is 15. Let us take one more calculation. G of 2, 4. G of 2, 4 is minimum of C of 2, 4 plus this 4 we are going to write here. G of 4, if this is a set 4 minus the element 4, it becomes 5. So G of 4, 5. And the value available is here, that is 10 and 8. The value we'll get is 18. In the same logic, you can find here G of 3, 2 will be 18. G of 3, 4 will be 20. G of 4, 2 is 13. And G of 4, 3 will be 15. Now, this is one more intermediate calculation we have done. Now, we are at this particular level. It means if I am at vertex 2, I need to travel to vertex 3 or 4 or 4 or 3. If I am at vertex 3, I have to travel to vertex 2, 4 or 4, 2. If I am at vertex 4, I have to travel to vertex 2, 3 or 3, 2. So to represent this, I am going to write it in this manner. G of 2, 3, 4. It means I am at vertex 2. I am going to travel either to vertex 3 or to vertex 4. So this is the values that I am going to calculate. Let's try to find G of 2, 4. And these value already we have calculated. Minimum of C of 2, 3. These 3 came here. And from the set we subtract this 3. So remaining is 4. So G of 3, 4. Then C of 2, 4. We got it here. And this 4 we are going to write here. And from the set 3, 4 we have to subtract 4. So the remaining is 3. So G of 2, 3 plus G of 3, 4. And C of 2, 4 plus G of 4, 3. Out of these two, I have to take the minimum. So I am having C of 2, 3 is 9 and G of 3, 4 is 20. So it becomes 9 plus 20. And the same way, C of 2, 4 is 10 and G of 4, 3 is 15. So the value is becomes 25. I got here 25. In the same fashion, I can apply and find all other values. That is G of 3, 2, 4, G of 4, 2, 3. So in the same fashion, I can find. These are the value already I have calculated. Now, I am at this particular vertex and I have to travel to either 2, 3 or 4. So G of 1, 2, 3, 4, I have to find. These calculations already I am having. So G of 2, 3, 4 will be C of 1, 2 plus G of 2, 2, 3. Then G of 1, 3 plus G of 3, 2, 4. And G of 1, 4 plus G of 4, 2, 3. I hope by now you understood how to write it. Still then I am explaining one. C of 1, 2. First pair I have taken. The 2 value came here and from the set given 2, 3, 4, I have deducted 2. So I got 3, 4. Similarly, C 1, 3 for 3 written here and from the set 2, 3, 4, I have deducted 3. Left out is 2, 4. All these values already we have calculated. Let us see. C of 1, 2 is 10 and G of 2, 3, 4 is 25. So I got this value. Similarly, C of 1, 3 is 15 and G of 3, 2, 4 is 25 and C of 1, 4 is 20 and G of 2, 23. So I got these values to be 35. Now I could able to ensure that my cost of travel will be 35. Earlier also by using brute force method, we have seen the cost of travel will be 35. Now to decide which path to travel to get the minimum cost 35. Now 35 came from where? This value. And this value comes from this particular calculation. C of 1, 2 plus G of 2, 3, 4. Now C of 1, 2 value is what? 10. And what is the value of G of 2, 3, 4? Already we have calculated. G of 2, 3, 4 is nothing but C of 2, 3 plus G of 3, 4 and this. So the value we got is 25. And 25 I got it from the second part. And this is the value I am having. C of 2, 4 plus G of 4, 3. So G of 2, 4 is 10. I am already having. So what is the value of G of 4, 3? I have already calculated. This is nothing but 15. And 15 how I got? C of 4, 3. Plus this amount. C of 4, 3 is nothing but 9. And what is the value of G of 3-5? G of 3-5 is the value 3-1, that is the value 6. So this is how the cost becomes 35. And now you know how to solve the traveling salesman problem. Let us see its time complexity. So this is the formula we have used. And for each one of the n possible i's, there is at most 2 to the power n paths. It means if there are n vertices and the salesman is traveling from vertex 1, then he will be having n minus 1 remaining vertices. So to cover the n minus 1 remaining vertices, he will be having 2 to the power n minus 1 different paths. And S is a subset of size n minus 1. And there are n values of I. And so n into 2 to the power n minus 1 will be the value of G of IS. So that's why the time complexity will be big O of n square 2 to the power n minus 1. I hope you understood how to solve traveling salesman problem and how to find its complexity. If you understood, give me a like and say among your friends. In our next video, we are going to talk about yet another application of dynamic programming. See you then. Take care. Bye.